Hello my friends and welcome to the channel and welcome to my DD2 New Players Guide series. I'll leave a link in the description below to the playlist for all the episodes if you want to check those out. Now in this episode I'm not really going to play any given map, I just want to talk to you about one of the most challenging modes in the game, and that is Mastery Mode. Mastery Mode, let's go into Advanced, is well worth trying and doing, because as you accumulate points in form of stars by doing these missions, you can unlock unique rewards that aren't available anywhere else in the game. Remember I said it's challenging, don't be put off, persevere, and the rewards are well worth having. So let's just give you an example. Chaos, if we go to Chaos 1 and we say the region, let's just pick, I don't know, Dragonfall Castle, and we'll choose Ramparts Siege, for example. The obvious difference here, when you choose a map, is these conditions that are over and above the normal survive, make your way through all the waves that you do in all the other modes. So here you've got survival waves, which is standard. Not even a scratch. No cores, your crystal cores, etc. Fall below 90% health, and that is in any wave. So if that happens and your cores get damaged, below 90% health, you'll fail this condition. You don't fail the game, you just fail that element. So that in each mission here on Mastery Mode, there are 5 potential stars available. The last one here, Perfectionist, basically means if you've earned all the other 4 above, you will get this 5th one. So the 5th one isn't unique to the mission, it's standard across all. Now every map will be different and you get some really challenging restrictions or conditions. Under pressure, finish each combat phase in under 180 seconds or 3 minutes. That just means kill everything as quickly as possible. State of decay, no defenses are repaired. Now if you've been playing for a while outside Mastery Mode into Chaos level and you've been running around defending your cores, and invariably what you will be doing is you will have been repairing defenses as you go, either during the combat phase or during the build phase. You're not allowed to do that in this mission. You can upgrade them, and if you're not familiar, upgrading will automatically fill the health to maximum at that new upgrade level of a defense, so you can use that in a way diligently. Don't just upgrade, because you want to use that when the repair state is dire. So use an upgrade instead of repair. So that's this one. Now the other thing that's not so obvious, let's just create this. So here we are in Mastery Mode Rampart Siege at Chaos 1 level, and the restrictions, conditions for this mission that we just saw on the previous screen are in place. But a more subtle thing that people don't necessarily realise jumping into Mastery is that if you look in the bottom right of your screen there, you've got this statement that gears, stats and ascension points are capped. Now, my character here, this monk, is essentially like a Chaos 7 level. He's got a few Chaos 8 relics, etc. But we went into a Chaos 1 Mastery Mode. What that means is, if I show you his stats, all his equipment, if you look at, basically this is a Chaos 6 helmet, but if you look at the stat there, it's drastically reduced. Its cog score down at the bottom right is 383, whereas in reality, back in the tavern, for example, you'd see a Chaos 6 is more in several thousand. And that's true of all his gear, including relics. You notice they're all in the 300 range, 400, just touching on that. And that's true of any hero you've got. Now these are sort of Chaos 2. You see the top left of any piece of gear, it's quality Chaos 2, but it's been reduced to a statistic more akin to Chaos 1 because we're in Chaos 1 Mastery, and that's one of the things that happens. It'll also, if we look at the monk again, it'll also have capped your ascension points if you've been accumulating those. Now my monk, like I said, it's a late game character, 528 overall. You can appreciate this would have been a proportion of that in the hundreds, and they've been assigned, but they will have been capped such that they're not as effective. So if you would need a reminder of the conditions in Mastery Mode in this particular mission, press escape And here's the conditions. Now, these are filled in because I have completed this successfully with all five, but there would be an outline of a star here for any that you haven't successfully met that challenge. So be very mindful of these as you're playing through the map, so you don't worry if you don't hit every one of these conditions in one playthrough of this map. You can come back to it. The other ones will already be filled in as stars you've earned. The ones you're yet to achieve, which will include this one because you haven't previously earned all of them, will be grayed out. But, you know, go for it, give it a go, really try. Mastery mode does force different strategies of you, and you might think, I like what I do, I don't want this to happen to me, I don't want to have to do it in a certain way. Well, it's not a certain way, there are a multitude, any number of ways of playing any given map. It just, you know, forces you to try different things, and that's good, because, you know, later on in Onslaught in particular, there will be resistances to certain defences. And, you know, if you've played Mastery, you've endured a Mastery level, you'll be well armed, well familiar with the fact that you can't always build what you want to build. Here's the thing. If we look at our monk here on his Lightning Strikes relic, I've got this golden shard called Mass Destruction. So you might be familiar by this stage with Destruction, a Chaos 1 shard, but you can only get Mass Destruction and a couple of others from Mastery mode. So if you get 10, I think it is 10 stars, or it could be 50, so you do 10 maps, more likely 50, you can unlock earn this. Now you can only get one of them, and so selectively choose which defense you want to really boost. And what that does, Destruction, when upgraded, and in this case gilded, will increase the defense power of the affected tower by 42%. Mass Destruction stacks on top of anything else like that and will increase the defense power by a further 34%. You notice under there it's got 16 of 34 and its upgrade path. These shards are very expensive to upgrade, therefore if you go in later onto ancient power resets, just be mindful that you need a lot of gold really to recover the stats back up to, in my case, like 16 of that 34, many millions, a couple of million. That's Mastery. And a further down the road of beating these Mastery modes, on an example of another unlock shard you can get is here on our weapon manufacturer of my series EV2, and it's this one called Vicious Strikes. Now Deadly Strikes is the one that increases the range, that's a Chaos 3 shard, and the unique one to Mastery that affects range, it's called Strikes, but it's Vicious Strikes, increases the defense range further, but it talks in terms of unit points. And really all you need to know is it's a major boost to range, such that my weapon manufacturer is well able to tackle air lanes from the ground. It's got a massive radius now on that aura. So that's Mastery. Like I say, I'm not going to play through these maps with you. Just be very, very, very mindful of the conditions for each map. Very different. Some really challenging ones across different chaos modes. Be very aware also that it nerfs your abilities. This is a Chaos 1 map. If you went into a Chaos 2 and so on, your stats will be capped back to what is considered around the maximum stats for that Chaos level. So, yeah, you will be slower, you'll be less powerful, but the enemies are Chaos 1. I'm on Chaos 1. My defenses have been capped to Chaos 1. It should be a good fight. Give it a go. Enjoy, relish the challenge, don't shy away from it. Those rewards are well worth having. Hope you give it a try. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.